Hi folks, today our video features a slight different panel. It should be noted that it was one extraordinary Futaba VFD for which we unfortunately have no documentation. This VFD is unusual because it was cheap in glass technology, but the control of the grids has to be external because they have 9 external pins. The position of the grids on the panel is out of the order. They are 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1 and 2. But the order of the pins start on the right at pin 1 and go up to 9 at left. The panel has a microcontroller that is responsible for controlling the both VFDs, and the smaller one belongs to the radio, has a VFD driver for positive voltage reference micro PD 16310. As I said, it is for positive voltage and reach pins 21 and 44. Note that this voltage is near of the 50 volts, which if you try to measure it while it is working, can cause damage to the driver if the multimeter pins touch incorrectly, since next to them we have both VSS1 and VSS2, which as a rule are connected to each other. VDD is the plus 5 volts to power logic of the driver. It can be deduced that the second VFD is a normal controlled VFD, in this case by a positive voltage driver. It is important to note, however, that this driver allows rotations both to left and to right. This is achieved by polarizing the pin R/L when low, which is the case in this panel, is connected to the GND. The data input pin is B. Other way will be A. I applied shots as important points of this input driver, but I didn't dedicate time to them so that the video would not be too long. The large panel has a set of the PNP and NPN transistors for controlled grids. Once recovered to be able to put the panel into operation, the presence of the CAN bus emulator is necessary, which in this case is achieved through a board with MCP2515 controlled by Arduino. We only have two sockets on the panel, a gray one for where arrive 12 volts DC and the CAN bus, while the red socket is for the radio, but is responsible for activating the clock and the temperature display information. As I referred, the grids start at left with a 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1 and 2. The hours stay blinking after the power is disconnected, and to set the clock you keep the pressure on this button. The hours stay blinking and you can advance the hour. If you wait some time, the minutes blink and you can adjust the minutes also. And okay, it's finished. As I said, this video is not about repairing the panel, as there are already many available. But since we had to bring it to life, there is nothing like revealing the difficulties we encounter. The critical 6 ampere fuse and the 12 volts DC positive coil with the solder broken, which cause burn again the fusible. One of the MOSFET off bridge to the filaments have a short. These both MOSFETs are responsible to generate AC voltage to this filament. The power up coming from these both capacitors, and these are responsible to generate the AC voltage to this VFD, and are connected to this capacitor here. To do it the test with our VFD in standalone mode, I prepared a breadboard with a driver SN75518, and this driver will be responsible to control the grids of our VFD. After some time, we have successful to bring the VFD to life again. This is a cycle of test to the VFD. After a few hours around our VFD, it was possible to proceed with a basic control. Without the map of the segments and the correspondent with the positions in memory, it had to be done through trial and error. I let three basic animations show the control of the VFD. There may be a conflict with the names I assigned to the control pins. I put, for example, CS from chip selector, and it is CE from chip enable. But easy is not important, okay? This VFD is unusual because it used the chip in the glass technology, but the control of the grids is external and independent. By this reason, we need to use a SN75518 to control the 9 grids of the pin. To power up our panel, we have the +12 volts DC at first pin at left, and the GND at second pin. At right side, we have the CAN bus height. The second pin at right is the CAN bus low. We will use one Arduino to control the mode when the VFD is in the standalone, and also use the same Arduino to control the MCP2515. The connections are in the both blocks of the code, because we have one code to control the VFD standalone and one code to control the VFD in panel through the CAN bus. When I have the VFD in the standalone mode, I use two converters DC-DC in the breadboard. One is a DC-DC converter of the 5 to 12 volts DC, another is from 5 to 24 volts DC, and implement these both DC converters in serial mode to reach a right perfect in the panel, okay?